I remember looking at the Earth for the first time just shortly after we had launched. We had a nighttime launch, and within 9 minutes or so, we're in orbit. And I remember seeing the Terminator, where the light meets the dark on the surface of the Earth. There's an overwhelming sense of gratitude for the experience that so few humans have had, to be off the planet and look down at it, and look down and appreciate how beautiful it is and how perfect it is. We're so fortunate to live on such a perfect planet, positioned where it is in the solar system, and that we know of nothing quite like it. When you're out on a spacewalk, when you're outside, your helmet gives you essentially a 180-degree view of everything around you. In my last spacewalk, in January of 2020, I was riding on the robotic arm out to the AMS worksite, and we were waiting for one of those leak checks in between, and there was a period of time when there was literally nothing that we could do, and so they parked me on the arm above, you know, about 50 yards above the ISS during a night pass, and they were like, okay, you're gonna just have to sit here for 20 minutes. Without the obstruction of the atmosphere, without light being refracted, stars are much more distinct. They don't have that twinkle anymore. Everything is very crisp. And naturally, you see infinitely more stars and planets mixed in there that are sometimes hard to distinguish, but infinitely more. No atmosphere between you and it. And I was out there above the ISS, nothing between me and eternity. You can't have this experience and not be changed. It does affect you, but I think by and large is what you find, that it reinforces beliefs that you already had, because that is our fundamental tendency, to look for evidence that supports what we already believe. It reinforced the importance of stewardship of our planet and carrying those responsible practices with us as we go out and explore, return to the moon, go on to Mars to understand the origins of our own planet. It was an interesting time in those final weeks before we landed in April. We were watching this global pandemic occur. The magnitude of what was occurring on the ground was starting to become more and more apparent as the weeks wore on, and we knew it was going to affect how we arrived on the Earth, and that they were going to have to take different measures bring us home. We were asked to make a video that asked, what are your impressions of returning to the Earth during a global pandemic? And one of the things that Jessica and Chris and I did was we took some images out the window of the cupola, and I just spontaneously, while panning the camera around and taking some shots of my crewmates looking out the window, I panned along the Earth and I said,
an Earth in crisis is still an Earth worth returning to.
Just spontaneously, I don't know what made me say it. I think it was a good reflection of how we were feeling about, you know, our time up there. We appreciated it, and we had a new sense of the Earth below us, and saw that the entire planet was experiencing this event that in many ways unified us all, in much the same way that the International Space Station unifies us all, and that we still desired to return to our Earth in all of its greatness and all of its problems. It's still our home.
Subscribe for more space.